They are important because they contain one or two IIT main model questions. Okay. Did we look at the methods of preparation of all keens? Hello, sir. You know, for example, you want to prepare 2-butene. How to prepare it, sir? You can take 2-butyne and convert into this by adding A or B. You can take CH3, CHCl, CH2, CH3. By adding reagent X, you can get this. You can take CH3, CHOH, CH2, CH3. By adding Z, you will get this. You can take CH3, CHBr, CHBr, CH3. By adding Q, you will get this. Now, can you tell me what is Z, sir? What is Z? Not preparing. Concentrated H2SO4 at 170 degrees or Al2O3 at 350 degrees centigrade. This reaction is removing water called dehydration. What is it called? Dehydration. Dehydration of alcohols will give alkenes. What is this reaction? What is it? The alkyne is converted to alkene by controlled addition of hydrogen.
Hydrogenation.
The controlled addition of hydrogen happens either by using palladium, barium, sulfate and carbon, that is called a Lenglar catalyst. Or by using sodium and ammonia. If using sodium and ammonia, it is called a Birch reduction. What is it called? Birch. How can it, what is the difference between a palladium, barium sulfate, sodium and ammonia? In both the cases, you are adding only one hydrogen, not two. Controlled reduction. But what is the difference between these two? One and two. What is the difference? In one, hydrogens are added from same side. In two, hydrogens are added from opposite sides. One is called syn addition. The other one is called anti addition. Do you remember all this? Did we discuss all this or not? I don't remember. Hello?
No, sir.
Did we not talk about methods of alkenes?
No.
This compound is called ethyl chloride. Now we see preparation because I don't remember what I spoke to you. Of alkenes. An alkene can be prepared from alkyl halide, a compound that has a halogen atom locked to a carbon. If the halogen atom is locked to a carbon that is bound to only one carbon, called primary alkyl halide. Here the halogen is locked to a carbon that is locked to two carbons. It is called secondary alkyne. If the halogen is locked to a carbon, that is locked to three carbons like this, it is called tertiary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide, secondary alkyl halide, tertiary alkyl halide. There are how many types of alkyl halides? How many types? Primary, secondary, tertiary. Anyway, if the halogen of the alkyl halide of carbon 1, halogen of next carbon called beta carbon, the halogen is locked to a carbon called alpha carbon, is beta carbon. If the halogen locked to alpha carbon and hydrogen locked to beta carbon are removed, they can be removed by using alcoholic KOH. The Cl, the H are removed, you get CH2 double bond CH2. The reaction where HCl is removed is called dehydrogenation. The dehydrohalogenation of alkyl halides give what, sir? Alkenes. What is this compound called? Can you name this compound? Can you name this compound? Hello?
3-bromo, 2-methyl.
I have to number in such a way that the substitution. So I will be counting like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is having a methyl group on third carbon, bromo on second carbon. It is 2-bromo-3-methyl-pentane. When this compound is treated with alcoholic KOH, alcoholic KOH will always eliminate halogen along with the neighboring hydrogen. Now the problem is, this halogen is going along with the neighboring hydrogen. Br minus and neighboring hydrogen. Is it the third carbon's hydrogen or is it the first carbon's hydrogen, which is preferred? If the third carbon's hydrogen is lost, getting this product, CH3, BRH by CH double bond, CCH3, CH2CH3. If the first carbon's hydrogen is going, I am getting this CH2 double bond CH, CCH3, CH2CH3. There are two possible products. The first product is 3-methyl-1-pentene. The second product is 3-methyl-3-pentene. 1, 2. So there are two possible products when the alcoholic KOH is treated with the alkyl halide that has two different neighbors. Are we very clear? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now I want to know whether I am getting 1 or 2, which is a preferred product?
2.
2, sir.
About it. Whenever there is a dehydrohalogenation with alcoholic KOH, hydrogen is preferentially lost from that carbon, from that beta carbon, carbon to which acid is called alpha carbon. Its neighboring carbons are called beta carbons. Now in dehydrohalogenation, hydrogen is lost preferably from that beta carbon which has hydrogen. Poor becomes poorer. This is a carbon that is having only one hydrogen. It is poor. This beta carbon has three hydrogens, that is rich. Now the hydrogen has to get out. Hydrogen is not going out from the carbon that has more hydrogens, but it is going from the carbon that has less hydrogens. Poor is becoming poorer is called Sedgef rule. So in a dehydrohalogenation reactions, alkyl halides with what, sir? Alcohol keyword. Or a new age. H plus is lost from carbon.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Salam. Alaikum salam. The H plus is lost from that beta carbon which has what? Which has more hydrogens or less hydrogens?
Less hydrogen.
Has less number of hydrogen.
What is this rule called?
Sedgef.
That in this way we get stable alkene. What is a stable alkene? A alkene where C double bond C has more substitution. CH3, CH. How many beta carbons it has? Hello?
Two beta carbons, sir.
It's beta 1. Beta 2, let us say. Or you can say it is beta 1, it is beta 2, whatever the way. Carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4. Okay. Now, two products I am getting. If I treat with alcohol, KOH. If the double bond is coming between 2 and 3 carbons, this Br and this hydrogen got eliminated. If this Br and this hydrogen got eliminated, this product. Product 1, product 2. Which is major, sir? Which is major, 1 or 2?
1, sir.
1.
Because that is more substituted alkene. In case of 1, hydrogen is lost from this beta carbon 3, which has less hydrogens. In 2, the hydrogen is lost from that beta carbon which has more hydrogens. This product is called Sedgef product. It is called Hoffman product. The Hoffman product is usually minor. Sedgef product is major. Some 80% is this, 20% is this. Normally, if you are using alcoholic KOH, alcoholic NaOH, room temperature, only this. However, if you want only Hoffman product, you have to use a bulky base. bulky base or high temperature. For example, NaOH is a simple base. NaOCH3 sodium hydroxide is a simple base. If you take NaOCH to CH3, sodium hydroxide is a bulky base. If you are taking sodium tertiary butoxide, oh my God, it is a very bulky base. Such bulky base and high temperature, reactions of alkyl halides, Hoffman product. What is that product? Are you clean about that? Hello? Are you clear about that?
Yes, sir.
Are you clear about that? Look here. Now, this compound has how many beta hydrogens? Okay. This compound has how many beta carbons?
Three.
This is a carbon to which Br is locked. It is called alpha carbon.
Three.
How many beta carbons it has? Hello, how many?
Three.
Hello?
Three, sir.
It is a beta carbon, and it is a beta carbon. Yes? Now, let us see. This beta carbon has how many hydrogens? How many? Ayo, how many hydrogens this beta carbon has, man?
One.
Because carbon makes only four bonds, it should have only one hydrogen. How many hydrogens this beta carbon has?
Two.
How many hydrogens this beta carbon has?
One.
Okay. Yes, sir. Now let us make another similar question. We will work out. Let us write Br here. How many beta carbons it has?
Three.
This has a beta carbon like this. It has a beta carbon like this.
Three, sir.
Now I want to know this beta carbon has how many hydrogens?
Three, sir.
Three.
This beta carbon has how many hydrogens?
One, sir.
Somebody wrote nonsense, so I cleared it off. If you are writing, I have to clear, you know. Otherwise, it creates confusion. Okay. Now let us count. How many beta carbons it has?
Three.
Beta one. Beta 2, beta 3. How many hydrogens it has, sir? 2. Here it has how many?
1.
It has how many?
0.
2. Why 0?
No, sir, 2.
Carbon should make 4 bonds. So can you see how many beta hydrogens each fellow has? Now, when this is treated with alcohol KOH, I am writing possible products. If this Br and if this hydrogen are lost, I get a double bond. If this Br and if this hydrogen are lost, I get a double bond. If this Br and if this hydrogen are lost, I get a double bond here. Auntie, boy, chutney. What is the major product, sir?
A.
Auntie. Yes, because hydrogen is lost from this beta carbon, which has less hydrogen. So it is said a product. I think I discussed all this with you. Again, I am talking about the same. I am feeling shortlist. Did I not discuss this? Hello? Did we not look at the methods of preparation of alkenes? Oh my God, he's not here. Hello, are you seeing the screen? Hello?
Yes,
yes. Hello.
Yes, sir.
What are these 1 and 2? 1 butene, 2 butene. What type of isomers they are?
Position isomers.
Very good. What type of isomers are these C and D? 2 methyl but 2 ene, 3 methyl but 1 ene. What type of isomers they
both
are?
Both. No, only position
isomers. Position isomers.
Perfect. What about A and DR?
Position A and chain.
And D, no, position is one only. Pent one ene. This is D is 3 methyl but 1 ene. Double bond is there in position one only. Only they are differing in nature of carbon chain. They are chain isomers. How A and B are related here?
A is cis geometrical isomer, B is trans.
If there are two carbons X is on the same side, then that is cis. If the X is on the opposite side, that is trans. You can see cis but 2 ene, trans 2 butene. Which has a higher boiling point?
Cis.
Why cis has higher boiling point? Because it is having more dipole moment.
Is more stable, sir.
Forget about stability. Boiling point is related to dipole moment, charge separation. In cis but 2 ene, there is a lot of dipole moment. Methyl group is electron releasing. You can see here how electrons are flowing. sp3 carbon low electronegative. sp2 carbon more electronegative, so electrons are flowing from methyl to sp2 carbon. Both vectors are pointing same direction. If charge is flowing in same direction, then the dipole moment, di means two, pole means opposite charge, flow of charges is more in A, cis to butene. Its dipole moment is measured as 0.33 debye units. Whereas if you are looking at trans 2 butene, from methyl to carbon, one vector is coming in upside. In another methyl to carbon, another vector is coming downside. They are canceling. So net dipole moment is zero. If the dipole moment is zero, molecule is less polar and its boiling point will be less. So anyway, We have looked at cis trans isomerism. What is this method of preparation of alkene? Alkene is added with hydrogen. Only one mole is added to one mole alkane. It is called controlled reduction. If I am adding palladium barium sulfate, across the triple bond, only one pi bond breaks. Two hydrogens are added from same side.
Sir, you are not audible, sir.
Hello, could you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. No.
Suddenly we got disconnected, right? Hello?
Sir.
We got disconnected, right? Sometime back? Hello?
No, sir.
So I was showing you the screen and I was talking. I was saying that palladium barium carbonate can add the hydrogens from same side to an alkyne. If this is the alkyne called 2-butyne, if you are adding two hydrogens atoms from the same side, then that is called as syn addition. If you are making syn addition, one mole of alkene added with one mole of hydrogen, you are getting cis-2-butene. What is that? Cis. To a triple bond, if we add both groups on the carbons linked by multiple bonds from same side, it is called syn addition. Syn addition always gives cis product. To make syn addition, you have to use palladium, barium sulfate and carbon as catalyst. So hydrogen is added in place of palladium, barium, sulfate, carbon. Both hydrogens are added from same side to a triply bonded carbon. So you get cis-2-butene. This is called a Lindlar catalyst. What is this called, sir? Lindlar's catalyst. Have you understood this idea?
Yes.
However, if you are adding the hydrogen, one mole is added. See, actually, if there is a triple bond, it can take 2 moles of hydrogen per mole. If you are adding 2 moles of hydrogen, you get alkane. To add 2 moles of hydrogen completely, you require nickel as a catalyst. We are not interested to make alkanes. We are interested to make alkenes. So you should not add 2 hydrogens. You should add only 1 mole of hydrogen. It is called controlled reduction. To bring about controlled reduction, you have 2 reagents. One is palladium, barium sulfate and carbon. The other one is sodium and ammonia. Sodium and ammonia. Palladium, barium sulfate, carbon is called a Lindlar catalyst. The Lindlar's catalyst would add both hydrogens from same side. The sodium and ammonia addition is called a Birch reduction, B-I-R-C-H, Birch reduction. Here both hydrogens are added from opposite sides. If one hydrogen is added from top, another hydrogen is added from bottom. In Birch reduction, only when 1 mole of hydrogen is added from opposite directions, It is called anti-addition. In anti-addition, you will get a trans product. So what is this, sir? Trans 2-butene. What is this, sir? Cis 2-butene. If I am starting with 2-butyl, if I want this, what is the reagent? If I want this, what is the reagent? If I want a trans product, I have to add hydrogens from opposite sides. The reagent is sodium or ammonia. That is Butch reduction. If I want cis, I have to add both hydrogens from same side, then the reagent is palladium carbon barium sulfate. This is called a Lindlar catalyst. Okay. So yesterday I think I talked about all this. Again, we are talking on the same, means our syllabus can never be completed anyway. Whereas in other section, we have completed the properties of alkenes. Okay. So first thing is controlled reduction. Second thing is alkyl halide dehydrohalogenation. In the dehydrohalogenation, in the textbook, they did not talk about Sage-Jeff rule, but I talked about it. From vicinyl dihalides, compounds which have two halogens on the adjacent carbons are called weak dihalides. When a weak dihalide is heated with zinc in carbon disulfide, ZnX2 is removed. So ZnBr2 is removed, you get a double bond. When an alcohol is heated with a concentrated sulfuric acid at 170 degrees, or when it is heated with aluminum oxide at 350 degrees centigrade, the OH group of alcohol and the beta carbon's hydrogen are removed as water. The removal of water is called dehydration. Hydro means water. You see, dehydration happens with concentrated H2SO4 because it loves to swallow water. Due to that, you are getting ethene. Dehydration of alcohol gives ethene. These are the four methods suggested in the book. Alkenes are also, lower members are gases, middle members are liquids, higher members are waxy solids. For every rise of one carbon, the boiling point increases by 20 to 30 degrees. Branched alkenes have lower boiling points than linear chains. What are the characteristic reactions of alkenes, sir? Hello? Hello, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Always I will be getting this out. What are the characteristic reactions of alkenes? Alkenes undergo free radical substitution. Do you remember them? Alkenes, CnH2n+2. Free radical substitution. Do you remember that reaction, sir? Hello? For example, if you take methane and react with chlorine, you will be getting methyl chloride and HCl. Further, it can give methylene chloride and HCl. So on. This reaction, first chlorine when exposed to light gives Cl radicals. The Cl radical combines with methane to give methyl radical and HCl. The methyl radical can combine with chlorine to give methyl chloride and chlorine radical. The first step is called chain initiation, starting. The second and third steps are called chain. What do you call them? Chain? Propagation. Once you have this CH3 radical, if it combines with Cl radical, reaction stops. Even when a methyl radical combines with another methyl radical, reaction stops. So this is a reaction where you are generating atoms or species with unpaired electrons called free radicals. Reaction where one free radical reacts with another free radical stops the reaction. It is called a chain terminating step. Therefore, reactions of alkanes are proceeding in a chain mechanism. What is these reactions are called? Free radical substitution. Who is showing that reaction? Alkanes.
Okay.
I think we talked about them. Did we talk or not? Hello?
Sir, you are not audible.
I am waiting for you to respond. Did we talk about free radical substitution?
Yes, sir.
Alkanes undergo free radical substitution. Example, chlorination of methane. It is generally called halogenation. The reaction has many steps. The reaction happens in presence of light. Any reaction that happens in light is called photochemical reaction. First, chlorine is exposed to light. Then the molecule breaks to give two Cl radicals. That breakage is called homolytic fission. Then the Cl radical can combine with methane to give a methyl radical and HCl. The methyl radical again combines with chlorine to give chlorine radical and methyl chloride. Step 2 and 3 can repeat millions of times. Hence, they are called chain propagation steps. Step 1 is called chain initiation. 2, 3 are called